So this screencast is part two of screencasts discussing the properties of fluids. In the first screencast, we discussed density and the bulk modulus. In this screencast, what we're going to talk about is the vapor pressure and surface tension. So let's start with the vapor pressure. So the vapor pressure, when you have a liquid and a vapor, and they're in equilibrium, the vapor is said to be saturated, and the pressure that the vapor exerts on the liquid surface is known as the vapor pressure. And when the absolute pressure in the fluid equals the vapor pressure, boiling occurs. So its importance to fluids lies in the fact that very low pressures can develop in a flow due to fluid motion. So when this pressure is reached, boiling occurs. And these bubbles can then flow into a movement of higher pressure, which then the bubbles collapse and it has enough intensity to cause structural damage. And this process is known as cavitation. So, in other words, when these bubbles burst and cause this kind of damage, that's cavitation. So, many engineering problems involve finding the point of lowest pressure in a system to ensure that this is above the vapor pressure. Generally, this pressure will occur at the highest point of the system since pressure increases as you go down in height. So the higher the cavitation number, the bigger the difference between the pressure of the system and the vapor pressure. Therefore, it's less likely that cavitation will occur with a higher cavitation number. So now let's talk about surface tension. So surface tension, and we abbreviate this as sigma, occurs due to an imbalance of the cohesive forces at the interface. And this is usually between a liquid, so we have liquid here, and we have some kind of gas on the surface, but it can also occur between two immiscible liquids. So in the interior, right in here, the molecules are equally attracted to each other. However, here, the molecules on the surface are subjected to a net force towards the interior. This tensile force is known as surface tension, and it has units of newton per meter. So let's consider the forces that are acting on, let's say, half of a liquid drop here that has a radius of r. So we have forces that are due to surface tension that oppose the forces due to a change in pressure between the interior and the exterior. So a force balance says that 2 pi r, which is the radius of the drop, times the surface tension has to equal that change in pressure times its area, pi r squared. So from that, we can determine what that change in pressure is, 2 times sigma divided by r. So one of the phenomena associated with surface tension is capillary rise. So if we have a small tube and it's inserted into water, what will happen is the water in the tube will rise above the level of the outside water. So here's your water, and what will happen here is you'll get what's known as capillary rise. And so a force balance is going to give us that H is, which is the height above the water level, is equal to 2 times the surface tension times the cosine of theta. And this is divided by the specific weight times the radius. And this theta is equal to what's known as the contact angle. And the way we calculate the contact angle is if you draw a line coming from that dip due to the capillary rise, the angle between that and the tube itself is what's known as theta. So surface tension is a measure of a fluid's attraction with itself. So a drop size in this scenario depends on how long a drop will stay and accumulate on the pin. So if the fluid is more attracted to itself, there'll be less surface area between the forming drop and the pin. As a consequence of less surface area, the attraction between the pin and the liquid will be less, requiring less liquid mass to break the mass attraction. So with this, we're going to finish up the four of the properties that determine fluids, our vapor pressure and surface tension here, and our density and bulk modulus on a previous screencast. In addition, take a look at our viscosity screencast that describes an extremely important fluid property, viscosity, and its relationship to an extremely important fluids concept, shear stress.